everyone. Welcome to the U.S. Open Health Desk, presented to you by Mount Sinai. I am your host, Shauna Ryan, and joining us today is Dr. Daniel Kaplivsky. He's the director of the Mount Sinai School of Medicine Travel Medicine Program. Doctor, thanks so much for joining us today.
It's a great pleasure to be here with you, Shauna. Thank you.
Well, today we're talking about my favorite topic, travel. And whether you are a college player heading off to play against another school, or if you're a senior player heading off to league nationals, or you're a pro heading overseas, travel can become a major component in your game and your performance. So today I want to talk about ways that we can maximize our performance. I'm curious, Doctor, what do you recommend to players who are traveling to places with drastically different climates?
It's a great question, Sean. It's one that athletes especially face as they move from time zones and different climates and different altitudes. So one of the things that can help athletes be at their best is preparation, and that means arriving at the destination ahead of time. So a few days to a week can really help a player acclimatize to a different altitude or climate.
What about if you're traveling somewhere with totally different altitudes? Like if you're going from Queens here at the U.S. Open, or you're going to the Rocky Mountains suddenly?
Sure. You know, it's a whole physiology of the way that we adapt to higher altitudes, and that has to do with the levels of oxygen that are available to the body. And athletes are particularly susceptible to the problems related to high altitude sickness. So the key thing is to try to adapt to the new altitude a few days in advance, because the body has the natural ability to do that. In addition, the body's requirements for hydration go up a lot. So taking care of lots of hydration can also help that adaptation period.
Any specific amount of water that you should be drinking when you're trying to fight these kinds of effects?
That's a good question. For each athlete, it's going to vary depending on how much exertion they're doing. So one guide is to try to make sure that the urine stays dilute. You know, so as long as your urine is coming out relatively dilute, that's a good indicator that you're keeping up with your needs.
And nutrition is also equally as important as hydration. What would you recommend there for nutrition?
It's a great question as well, because a lot of times, you know, we think about the water, we don't think about the salt. And salt is an equally important part of staying hydrated, along with potassium and glucose. So for the typical athlete's diet, you're going to get enough salt. It's just making sure you keep up with the water component along with that.
You know, some people have to travel for extended periods of time on a plane, and that can really affect your performance. What can you do to minimize the effects of long airplane travel?
Yeah, long airplane travel is a special scenario where you might be stuck in a chair for several hours at a time. So we tell all of our travelers to make sure they get up once an hour or so, just to make sure they get to stretch and make sure the blood is flowing to try to prevent blood clots.
Yeah, I think that's really important. You always hear people say, just get up. It may look a little weird, mm-hmm. but it's good for you on the plane.
That's
do it.
Right. Exactly.
And finally, any tips that you have for once you arrive on site that can help you out?
Yeah, you know, I think a lot of people, when they get to a destination, want to get right into their training routine. For places that are high altitude, Mexico City, Cusco, I think those kind of first few hours are important to rest and let your body acclimatize to that lower oxygen level before you get back into your intense training routine.
Great. Well, Dr. Kaplivsky, thank you so much for coming here today, giving us some great travel tips. We really appreciate it.
My pleasure.
And don't forget, you can check out usopen.org throughout the entire tournament for more tips from the staff at Mount Sinai. Until next time, I'm your host, Shauna Ryan. We'll see you right here on the U.S. Open Health Desk, presented to you by Mount Sinai.